Look in the mirror, say, bitch, I'm the best, 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 best. Way too blast, 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 blast. Bitch, I'm the best, best, best.
Hey, loves, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing knotless box braids. I haven't did braids in like a, not, I wouldn't say braids. I have not done box braids, knotless box braids in quite some time. I think like a month or so. Because last time I had box braids, it was just regular box braids. But now today I'm doing knotless. I bought two packs of hair because one, I'm doing them short. And two, knotless always uses less hair. I don't know why. I don't know what it is. But you just use less hair, you know? So I did buy two packs of beads. I was going to buy one, but you know, you can never go wrong with more beads. And you don't know if you have enough, so I bought two. These are the beads I bought. Fire. And I bought this color because my hair is light, so I just wanted some type of gold in my hair. And I bought two packs of this 613 color. I should have more than enough because one, I'm going to cut it in half. Plus, each pack come with two bundles in it, so that's four bundles altogether, so I should have more than enough. You know, and it's gonna be short, so why not? So before we get started into this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Okay, do all that good stuff and turn on your notification bell so you can be notified every time I post a new video. I did wash my hair yesterday, but today I rinsed it, like I just rinsed the conditioner out, and so I could get ready to blow it out and stuff like that, because I always like to blow out my hair before I braid it. It just, it's easier, you know, it's easier. Okay, I'm not gonna blow it out on camera because that's just too much work right now. I was gonna get a pack. It was kind of similar to my hair, but not really. So I was just like, let me just stick to one color and just try to seal in the ends as best as I could, you know. And I'm also gonna be using this Shining Jam. And then afterwards, first I'm gonna blow my hair. Then I'm gonna use this oil for my scalp because my scalp is dry. I don't get dandruff, but my scalp is still dry. Don't know why, but. Then I'm gonna use this to braid, and then I'm gonna use some mousse to seal the end. Like, you know, when I'm done, I'll just put some mousse on and then a do-rag, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, the length is gonna be, I think I wanna do it like right here. A bob type. I don't know if I wanna do it right there. I'm gonna blow my hair real quick and do all that stuff. And then I'll get back to you. All right, guys, so I blow dried my hair already. Ooh, I like that. I like that light. You see that light, this light area? That's how I want it in my whole head. But it's always the next time, because guess what? I got more bleach in my drawer right now. But I'm not going to do it right now. But this is how it looks blown out. Whatever. I have to part it now. I also have white rubber bands. I forgot to mention that. And I'm also thinking about using gel as well, just to seal the ends instead of using that. Because that could be sticky at times, you feel me? So I don't want everything too, you know? So I only have a little bit, but that should be fine. That should be enough. I'm using white because my hair is light and the hair is white, so kind of you want to blend that in. If I use black, you're gonna be able to see it. So I got me some matcha latte, because if you're watching this video right now, bro, go to Dunkin Donuts, right? Of course, during the day, you know. So if you're watching this now at night, just go in the morning. You want to get a green matcha latte, right? Iced. Okay, iced with French vanilla syrup inside, okay? Thank me later, all right? Just thank me later, that's it, thank me later. They also have this drink in Starbucks, but Starbucks matcha is way too strong. I don't like that. I even tried it with pineapple syrup before from Starbucks. It wasn't bad, you just gotta get used to it. So I'm gonna be parting my hair. I'm gonna use this comb because this just like gets everything. I'm gonna be using this mirror to see like my hair. By the way, if y'all want this mirror, I got this from five below. So I have to clean this mirror though, and I don't like that. I don't know what it is, but this light is yeah, it died. That's why it was so, I get it now. I also dropped it when I first got it, so yeah. So I'm gonna be using it to just see where I'm parting and stuff like that. So if I'm looking down, you know what I'm looking at. So you just comb it out, you know, you just comb it. I almost forgot, I have to put the oil. This is the Biotin Premium Hair Oil, natural hair loss treatment. I don't lose my hair, but it has biotin in it, so you can never go wrong with biotin. First of all, that's what helps your hair grow. And you know my bold ass. Everybody know my bold ass needs it. I don't want to put too much and then make my hair all, you know. Then you want to moisturize a little bit, baby. You want to moisturize. I'm feeling this color on me. I'm feeling it. I like to start in the front. I'm gonna braid from the back first, but you know, y'all get the idea. Y'all get it. So the trick to getting straight lines, first of all, like perfect lines, we're not gonna do this to the whole head because I'm not about to do that. Like, that's gonna take up hours. So I'm just gonna do it to the front of my head because that's the most part that's gonna be seen. So what you wanna do is part your hair first, right? We're gonna part the line in the middle, right? You always wanna measure it with your nose when you're parting, if you didn't know that. Cause you know, a lot of people, they be, you know, crooked with it. So you just, first of all, I'm gonna use this part first. See how it's not perfect, right? You see how it's not perfect, right? Oh, I missed the spot. All right, so now what you want to do is take some, whatever you call this, jam, and you want to go like this. Because that's what gets the hair like to be more neat, you know? See, if I do this to the whole head, I'm gonna be here all day, so we're not about to do that. Caught flashing another man. Yo, Dolce and Nisha is mad funny. Y'all gotta watch them. Last night, I was dying. Like, when he be screaming, I really be laughing mad loud. Because, like, you don't got high blood pressure? So, now, I'm not gonna be able to see if the sides are perfect because I mean, it looks perfect from here. Pretty much. So now I'm gonna take that and tie it up. Get that out the way, you know, get it out the way. I don't know. I do part each section. I don't part each piece because I feel like that just takes long. I don't know. I mean, not really, but you know, whatever. We'll see what happens. Because at the end of the day, y'all don't gotta wait because y'all get to see the next clip like that within the snap of a finger. Me, I gotta sit here and work on my head for hours. I'm not doing all that. That hurts. Part of my head, like, I be mad hard with it. All right, this line is more behind my ear. This one is, like, right at the ear. See how long it takes me just to part my hair? All right, so now we're gonna section off the back. I'm gonna show you how that looks in just a second. So, this is how the back looks, okay? And if it's crooked up here, then I don't know what to tell y'all. But all right, I'm gonna do this off of camera and I'll come back when I start braiding. So this is the final product. Let me stop. Bro, I look crazy. But yeah, this is how I part my hair, you know. I'm gonna do a little 360 real quick. Let me stop. But yeah. I didn't part like each individual because that would take up more work. But I just part the sections that I'm really gonna, like, you know, the sections I know I'm gonna braid. Let's say, all right, so basically this is gonna be two braids, you know, and so forth. Okay, I think I want to start in the back. This last time I did box braids, like short, I used this hair, but my hair was black at the time. I did a video on it, I think. But, yeah, the short box braids, knotless. And I don't remember how I did it. This is 30 inches. It doesn't seem like it. So, this is 30 inches. So, if I was to leave it long, it would be this long. But I want to do it short. So, cut it in a half. Yeah, I'm going to have to cut it twice. So that's what I'm gonna do. Where's the scissors, first of all? Okay, so we about to get started. I don't know yet, but this looks so cute. You're so pretty, girl. You're so pretty. All right, so you always start off with thin pieces, okay? Thin, like this. Like this, okay? I'm gonna put that right there. I like to use the same size throughout the whole thing because your hair gradually gets thicker anyways as you're, like, going to the bottom, you know? If that makes sense. All right, I have 5 pieces. I'm gonna take out 6 just in case. So I'm gonna pin up the rest of my hair. The front, I'm gonna just use another rubber band to get it out the way. Now I'm gonna pin up the back. So this is the back. Can y'all see that? I'm too close. So I'm gonna do back here first. I hope I like this color on me, like with this type of color, cause I'm gonna be them tight. Hopefully it's straight, because I don't got time for this. I'm going to take some of this jam and put it, like, at the roots. All right, so you're going to want to start with your real hair first. You're going to braid your real hair first at least 3 times, and then you're going to start adding the fake hair. You're going to see. Now, as you're braiding down, you want to add more jam or whatever cream, gel, whatever you're using, so that your ends could stay, you know? So I'm gonna just want to add more. Then you start adding your pieces in. So I like to grab it like this. Put my finger like this so I could put it underneath. Just watch closely. So you want to take your pointer finger, where your pointer finger is, you want to take that piece and put it underneath that pointer finger. So you just want to go like this, grab it, let go. Okay, now you want to add this piece to the fake hair right here. Grab that, start twisting in. Okay, now you keep adding, like I said, you want to keep adding gel, cream, whatever it is that you're using. We'll see. All right. So you do the same thing with this. Put it underneath the way I did. So I'm using 6 pieces on each. I guess that's gonna be my number. This color is just, I mean, I don't look that bad. I would use that gel, but that gel has a little tint to it. And I'm not trying to change the hair color. Yeah, 6 pieces is good. So when I'm done with all of this, I'm gonna boil my hair in hot water. Since it's not my roll hair, might as well. And then I'm gonna just seal the ends. So you wanna braid your real hair 3 times. 2 to 3 times, yeah. Add more. Especially where your real hair, where your real hair ends, that's where you want to add it so you can seal it. Because I'll be hating when my real hair sticks out. I'm going to try to do it this length now. This is fine. It's going to be in the back anyway, so it really doesn't, you know. This one does feel tighter though, I'm not gonna lie. But I don't have time to do it again, so it's staying like that. On to the next row. And this row is maybe gonna be 4 braids because I'm not doing them too small. That's gonna, especially me starting at, I started at 5, I think, 5 something. Me starting so late is just gonna take up extra time, so we'll see how that goes. I'm trying to measure it with my fingers to see how I'm gonna braid it. Comb that. Put some of this. Plus, I also put jam instead of gel because, like, at the roots on my rear hair in general, because gel gets my hair curly so fast. And we don't need that because we need our hair extended as much as possible. Take some. Sorry, I was rudely interrupted. So basically the braids is gonna be like right here, but I don't want to cut it yet because I need to add the beads still. So that's gonna end up being folded and then cut at the end, if that makes sense. Okay, well, I'm gonna just get the back done and then I'll get back to you guys when I'm at the top. Alright guys, I'm back. I did the back already. It looks long because, well, it is long because I tried to make all of them like even. You know, you see where the rubber bands are? I try to make all of them even as possible so I can just add the beads and then make my way from there. I did dip it in the hot water, but I'm gonna do it again afterwards. As you can see, I have the little pieces sticking out, but I can't dip my real hair in it because you're not supposed to. If I can't get all of them out, that's fine. Really don't care. Right now, I'm gonna just work on one side, I guess, on camera. I think I'm gonna make this one braid because I don't want to be here all day doing this. Like, yeah, I'm gonna do that one braid. I'm not gonna do this on camera. Like, I'm gonna just try to finish it so I can hurry up, and then I'm gonna come back to y'all when the beads and everything is on, because this video, if I keep it up, this video is gonna be 40 minutes long. Okay guys, I'm back. So I don't like them, I'm gonna be honest, you know. I didn't put the beads because the braids are too thick. I did the medium, so I grabbed small beads. I was looking at the medium ones too. That's the funny part. Like, I was really looking at them. Like, something was just telling me to grab them. But I don't feel like it would look right with this hairstyle. Like, I wouldn't like it personally. So, yeah. Let me close this closet. Messing up my video. Messing up the flow. I mean, for the most part, it's cute. You know, it's okay. This one's a little long. But, I don't know. I like it a little bit, but not to actually, like, wear for a long time. I'm gonna keep it in for like a couple days, I'm not gonna lie. And once it starts getting messed up, which I know it is already, because these type of braids get messed up fast, especially if they're bigger. So once they get messed up, I'ma just, you know, take them off. But I can, like, if I feel like they are getting messed up fast and I don't feel like taking them out too soon, I could just put like a scarf over it or something, like, you know, one of them little like that, you know. Let me see how it would look. These are knotless too, but I don't like knotless when I'm doing it big, because I don't know, it looks weird. So like, if my hair is messed up and I'm running to the store or something, you could just throw this on real quick. I'm gonna fix that now. See, I know how to come up with stuff, you feel me? And I'm not really bothered like that it didn't come out the way I wanted it to, because at least my hair is done. At least I did something to it. I really needed my hair done. Like, it was looking crazy. So I'm just happy I got something done to it. Oh, I don't look that bad. But yeah, if I want to go to the store and I'm in a rush. Throw on a headscarf. Whatever. You know, what are good stuff. But right now, I don't feel like keeping this on, so I'm going to take it out. Hold up. It looks funny when I do that, because it leaves a mark, but it's size decent, you know, chillin'. The back, I don't know, these braids are like, they get big. Cause I didn't do them this big, to be honest. It's like I said, it's like your hair swells up or something, like. But this is how the back looks. One more time. I like spending in this chair. But this completes the end of my video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was kind of a fail, but not really. Yeah, so at least I did something to my hair, whatever. But yeah, I'm gonna catch you on my next video. I have to, it's already 12 at night, and I have to edit this video because I'm trying to get it up as soon as possible. So yeah, stay tuned for this video. Stay tuned for the next one. Stay tuned for all that. Like, come on, just stay tuned. Put your notification bell on so you can be notified every time I post a new video. And you'll be good, okay? Trust me. I'll see y'all in the next one.